Hello friends, today we'll see the model 4 of your mechanical measurements and metrology. The model 4 talks about the generalized measurement system which is used in your mechanical engineering field. First we'll go through the content of the model number 4. The model number 4 consists of a definition, significance of the measurement and the generalized measurement system, and some important definitions. Some of the definitions are already covered in your module number 1, but there are some more definitions which we'll be covering in this module, that is accuracy, precision, calibration, threshold, sensitivity, hysteresis, repeatability. So there are some more definitions which we'll see one by one, and we'll see what is error and classification of the errors, how the errors are classified and what are the main reasons for errors in the measurement system. And after this we'll see the transducers, what are the transducers, what is transducer efficiency, what is primary transducer, what is secondary transducers, the transducers which are used for the measurement, that also we'll see, and what is the purpose of using the transducers in measurements, that also we'll see. So friends, we'll see the module one by one, the concepts one by one. First one is measurement system. See, the definition of the measurement system we have already studied in module number 1. What is measurement means, it is very simple. It is the process of comparing the unknown quantity with the known standard and getting the result. For example, suppose if you have something, suppose if you have some mass and you don't know the quantity of the mass, either it may be 5 kg or 10 kg, how to determine that is very simple. Comparing that mass with the known standards, for example, you will be having a weighing stones which are considered as the standards. By comparing them with the known standards, you can tell this is of this much weight. So that is a simple definition of your measurement, and you can see this through the block diagram which is mentioned in this slide. The unknown magnitude is there, and it is involved in the process of the comparison, that is called a measurement, and this is compared with the standard. The standard is something which is accepted by the everyone, which is, it may be accepted by the globally or it may be accepted by the local authorities, and you will get the result. So this is called the process of the measurement. And if the measurement, if you are concentrating measurement only in terms of mechanical field, then it is called a mechanical measurements. Okay, and most of the things here is just to determine the physical variables, whether the physical variables are determined or no, that we have see here. Next, what is the requirement of the measurement? The requirement of the measurements are only two. The first one is, the standard used for the comparison must be accurately known and commonly accepted. This is a very important. When you say something is a standard, that standard must be accepted by the everyone, and it must be known clearly to everyone what is this. Okay. The many examples you can say, when you say the length cannot be simply said to be too long, but it must be said it is comparatively longer than some standard. Okay. And the second requirement is, the procedure and the apparatus used for the comparison must be commonly accepted and must be provable. Whichever the apparatus or the instrument you use, and along with the procedure, whichever the steps you follow for the measurement, it must be commonly accepted, and the whichever the instrument you are using or the procedure you are adopting, it must be provable. Okay. Next, the significance of the measurement. This also you have studied already in module 1. The significance, there are many significance. because you know, without the measurement we cannot see the engineering field, or especially a mechanical field or civil engineering field. The measurement provides you the fundamental basis for the research and development. Any component, if you want to design any component, if you want to manufacture, the measurement is a very important role there. Without a measurement you cannot imagine of designing or manufacturing something. Okay, like this, the various significance are there. In these are not only in terms of not only in terms of mechanical field, in some other field also the measurements is there. The measurement may be involved in some power stations, like temperature measurement, pressure, vibration measurement. All those things are there. Measuring of each parameters which are involved in the process is very important. Okay, and next we'll see the generalized measurement system. See, generalized measurement system fall within the framework of the generalized arrangement, consists of three phases. It will be having a three phases or three stages. The stage one is detection or transduction, or it is a sensor transducer stage. In this stage, first you will detect what which parameter you have to measure. That will be detected in the stage one. The stage two is the intermediate stage, which shall be called as a signal conditioning stage. And third one is a terminating stage, or the readout or record stage. See this, you can go through the flowchart mentioned in this slide. There will be a unknown quantity which is detected first, that is called a stage one. And this stage one will be converted to the stage two through some signal conditioning devices. For this we will use some kind of transducers. Okay, the simple, what is this transducer means? It is very simple. Transducer is nothing but it is converting one form of energy to the another form of energy, or converting one form of signal to the another form of signal is called a transducer. Okay, use of this transducer, it will be shifted to the stage 2. In this stage 2, the transducers may require the auxiliary power supply, or sometimes they may not require any power supply, and then it will be compared with some known quantity which is called a standard. Then you will get the record, or you will get the result. Okay, and this generalized measurement system can be explained with example. You can give many example. Okay, I will give one example which is very simple, which is a Bourdon tube pressure gauge. Okay, in this slide the different example is given. This also you can refer, but the Bourdon tube pressure gauge is also given in your in this slide only. You can refer that also. In this Bourdon tube pressure gauge, the pressure has to be detected. Okay, the pressure will be considered as the input signal which is to be measured. Then through the Bourdon tube, which is considered as a conditioning signal or the stage 2, the Bourdon tube is going to contract. Because of this, it will be connected to the pointer with some kind of linkage links or gear system, and this pointer will give you some reading. Okay, the Bourdon tube pressure gauge, it is very simple. You might have seen the you can see in some puncture shops, like filling the air in the tires. Okay, and when you the shopkeeper will hold something and you will get the reading on the scale. Okay, what is the pressure inside the tire, air pressure inside the tire. That is a simple example. Means the pressure which is to be measured is considered as the input for the measurement. And the Bourdon tube is used as a secondary stage, where you will actually do the signal conditioning. Okay, or else you can give also the example which is mentioned here. Okay, the illustrate a very simple measurement. Let us consider the familiar tire gauge. The same example is also mentioned here. Here you can see the image, the tire gauge which will be used for checking the automobile tire pressure. The air pressure is considered as an input signal, and how it will be converted, you may provide some piston arrangements or you can provide the bore and tube pressure gauge, okay, which will be used for measurement of the tire. And there are some definitions in this module. These definitions will see one by one, okay, in the coming class. But before this, you must understand what is this generalized measurement system. The generalized measurement system will be carried in three stages. Stage 1 will be the detection stage, 2 is the signal conditioning stage, 3rd one is the terminating stage. And you have to explain this with a simple example, like your automobile tire pressure checking instrument or any other example you can give. Okay, so this is about the first half of your module number 4. Please go through this. Okay, I will share the PPT as well as the notes with this. You can read out any doubts, we'll discuss later in the class. Thank you.